regionals are coming to Salt Lake City this week, right? And I still realistically don't know what I'm going to be using. You know, I made a really cool Kyurem Black team for the, you know, Patreon tournament. I made the really cool Groudon Charizard team for the IC. But I don't know what I'm using at Salt Lake. And, you know, I really think that I just need a second set of eyes to help me realize what I could be using.
I think I have some good ideas.
You got some good eyes?
Yeah.
All right. So, basically, we're just going to be building a team around Pokemon that Kelly likes. And we're going to see if we can make it work. And you have a list of some Pokemon
right here.
That we have to use in this team. So, I guess, what is the number one Pokemon that you think that you want to use? What would you call it? Like, what would you call it?
The Tomb Mold guy.
The Tomb Mold. So, guys, if you were to... What's a Pokemon whose name is Tomb Mold? Because she doesn't know the names. Let's see. Let's open up this. Right here, because we have Showdown. All right. Tomb Mold guy. Let's go. So, Tomb Mold guy. That's a band, right?
Yeah, okay.
There you go. It's a shirt. Okay. All right. So, Tomb Mold. And what's the aesthetic that we're going for here?
Spooky.
All right, so we gotta go with a spooky team. Confagrigus, Runerigus. See, I'm more attached to, like, is it... Yeah, we gotta...
I have a feeling she bits? Has great taste. Yo. Yeah, you're right.
You're right. Yo, Lucky, thank you for the bits. Choo-choo, hype train complete. Is it this one? Not the Siglyph. Is it this Pokemon? Is this the one you're thinking of? This guy?
Yes.
All right, so we have to build around Spirit Tomb.
He's cool. He's super metal looking.
Do you like that version or the shiny version?
Oh. I like the pink.
All right. And then we got to name it Tomb Mold, right?
Tomb Mold.
Where do we put in the nicknames here? I know there's a place to do it. Whatever. We'll figure that out. It's right here. Look at me. Never like putting in nicknames ever. Tomb Mold. There we go. Look at us. All right. Spirit Tomb. We have a couple abilities. Normally when I build teams, I don't like to add all the different like bells and whistles until we get our six done, but we do want to put it into the team builder here. Spirit Tomb back in the day didn't used to have any weaknesses, and ever since they introduced fairy typing, well, it does have weaknesses. It has weaknesses to fairy. So we got Spirit Tomb right here, and again, you can see right there, our only weaknesses to that big fairy type. So we're doing okay.
Wow.
All right. What are some other Pokemon on your list? You have a full... She has a full list of, like, Pokemon. I can see the list here. And they just have, like, names of what, like, they look like.
So the next one, I want that evil tree.
The evil tree. So that... Obviously, that has to be Trevenant, I think.
That's a badass name, too.
Have you seen Shiny Trevenant, though?
Maybe.
What colors do you think the Shiny one is? Here we go.
Oh, that's cool.
You want to use the shiny? You want to use the evil tree? Which one?
Galaxy's a shiny.
All right, shiny, like evil tree ghost. Hyped. Evil tree hype. Well, I please hope don't want to ghost me. Like, just automatically loses to Calyrex. Okay, we got two Pokemon. What is the next one on the list?
I want the Gene Simmons skunk.
So, that has to be Obstagoon. Right? Right there. Has to be Obstagoon. Do you want the regular one? Or, what do you think a shiny looks like?
Oh, I don't know.
You didn't think that there'd be this much thinking to have to pick a shiny, right?
I guess, no, I didn't even think of all of them having shiny versions.
This one shiny is... You've actually picked three Pokemon whose shinies look completely different from the regular one. Like, even Spirit Tomb and Trevenant, they're so polar opposites. This guy...
No. No, thank you.
No, thank you. Okay, we'll go regular. And we'll go Gene Simmons. I don't think there's not enough room to do more, but we'll go Gene Simmons right there. All right, so we don't have any restricteds yet. So we have a couple other Pokemon that could be seen. There's three Pokemon on this list that I'm looking at here that could be, like, restricteds. The first one is... This one, what is that one?
The flying whale.
The flying whale. So
the Gojira Pokemon.
So that's probably going to be this thing?
Right? Yes.
Yes, okay. Yeah. Now, do you want the regular blue? What color do you think it is shiny?
Purple.
Purple. You're kind of right. It's like pink purple. Which one's better?
It's cute. I like the blue one, though.
Okay. All right. So we got Kyogre, and we will name it Flying Whale. Wayward? All right. Flying Whale. Disappointed it wasn't Wayward. It's not restricted. Yo, thank you for the follow. What does Wayward look like? Where, Wayward.
Oh, you.
Yeah, I can type it up here. Wayward. All right, there you go.
It's him.
Oh my god.
Like his little tiny eye.
All right, so are we using a Wayward?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
We got room.
No. No, I have others on my list.
But look how cute he is in his shinies. Like,
it's pretty cute.
Okay, so no Wayward. Anyways.
Big boy, yeah.
All right, so we got one more slot for restricteds, and you have two choices. You made a really good choice in Kyogre. It's the best restricted in the format. Good job. Goes really well with, like, Trevenant and stuff like that, too. Not gonna lie, this is a pretty balanced team so far.
Okay.
So, what's that one?
It's the antler guy.
The antler guy. whoop. There we go. All right, so we have antler guy. Oh, I typed in antler guy. It's this, right? Is that who you're talking about?
Yeah, that guy's cool.
All right, so you were going to pick Kyogre Xerneas, you know, the tied and true reindeer. What do you think looks like shiny? Yo, Hype Train successful. Thank you
green.
So much. You think it's green?
Should be green.
It's that.
Ooh.
You like that?
That's cool.
All right. Cool. We did we taking those. Like, you know, you got the white.
What about the other? I only get
two. No, you only get two, but the last one of your restricteds is...
The sword dog.
Sword dog. So... Obviously, remember how you guys said, like, you know, she has good taste? I mean, she literally picked Kyogre Zacian, knowing absolutely nothing about the game. So it's like, that's pretty good. What do you think its shiny looks like?
I don't know. I haven't been right on any of these.
You're right on Kyogre. Okay. So what do you think?
Yellow.
It's not. It's blue. Oh. So, like, you can make a team out of those two and have, like, the super cool... blue squad, but it's up to you. So someone says ditch Xerneas. So which two you got to pick? Two of these, which two do you want to keep?
I like the antler guy. I think he's cool.
All right, so you're gonna keep antler guy. All right, and then do you want the Kyogre or the sword dog?
Oh,
because either work, it's not like you're doing anything wrong.
Which one do you think is better?
So, like, we could build a team that uses the whale with, like, a really aggressive, like, choice scarf set and goes fast and, like, pins people. Or we can go, like, a little bit more of a trick room out. The sword dog's going to be easier to play in most situations. You kind of just bring out the sword dog. Also, sword dog has synergy with Xerneas. Xerneas' ability, right? Xerneas' ability is fairy aura, which boosts the power of all fairy moves, and Zacian is a fairy type. And also, these two look really cool together because they have, like, the blue-on-blue action.
Okay, we'll keep the sword dog.
Sword dog. Okay, so goodbye, Flying Whale. You say no redirection. Xerneas sucks. I don't think you just understand how good at Pokemon I am, right? I don't think you understand. We don't need redirection. You don't need it. I'll show you a way to play Xerneas without redirection. We still have a couple other Pokemon on this list. We have that one. What's that one?
The Goth Girl.
The Goth Girl. So that's going to be something like Gothitelle, right? Gothitelle's pretty good. And you have one more Pokemon on the list that we could use instead of all of these. And what's that?
Gengar.
Everyone knows Gengar, right? So it's like, and then we got Gengar, right? So it's like, these are our options. Replace Kyogre with Wayward. That, they're not wrong. That's, you're not even that wrong. It could totally work. but I think we have a cool option here for a little bit of, like, Trick Room. We could proc policy. We could use policy Gengar. So I know someone said, like, Parish Trap. I was telling you about that the other day. I was like, we can't go Parish Trap. Like, it'd be so hard. But let's see. I like the Gene Simmons Skunk. I like the Trevenant. Spirit Tomb is going to be really hard to make useful. But it's useful if we can proc policy.
Gengar would be good instead of Tomb.
So Spirit Tomb can be used. It's going to be used with, like, potentially, like, Shadow Sneak here to potentially, like... Does it get Sucker Punch, too? Awesome. So both these moves are priority moves, which means we can use these to proc policy on, like, something, right? So, like, we can pick a Pokemon who has, like, a dark weakness or, like, a ghost weakness, and we can give them a weakness policy and make them really, really strong. So what we would want to do is find, like, a ghost type.
What about Pumpkaboo?
What about Pumpkaboo? it's a Gourgeist right here. We have Trevenant. They do roughly the same thing.
Oh, he's so cute.
Let's think about this realistically. I don't think that would work. Has your girlfriend been on the channel before? She has. Yeah, she has. A few times. Yeah, I think we're going to go heavy Trick Room, but, like, we got to pick a Pokemon that we can policy Dragapult. Properly.
Is that the Spooky Newt?
We can use Dragapult. Yeah, Spooky Newt. That's Dragapult. Dragapult works.
Yeah.
So you can proc policy with your Spooky Newt and your Doom Mold. Pumpka. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so we got a shit ton of ghost weakness. Let's plug these guys into the team builder. We got that big Trev. So we got Trevenant. We got Obstagoon. We got Xerneas. We got Zacian. And we got Dragapult.
Were we going to change Spiritomb?
No, we can totally use Spiritomb. Or Trevenant. They both work there. We have big fairy weakness. Like on this slot, and on this slot. But we have mons that beat their fairies, like a Zacian, so we can be fine. Three ghosts. Yeah, but the thing is, like, it's fine. I don't think it matters. We're just going to win anyways. Yeah, you see
oh,
the fairy
we put
weakness.
Dragapult instead of Gengar.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Because Dragapult's better than Gengar.
Okay.
So we got to give ourselves some sort of shot to win the game. So that's what Dragapult's going to do. And everyone's like, you don't have any redirection. It's like, I'm about to in just a minute. All right, so we got these guys. As for the Dragapult, do you like the way that one looks? What do you think a shiny looks like?
Orange.
Orange. I wish, man. It is...
I kind of like the green.
This one's better.
I like that one, yeah.
This one's better. It's like super spooky purple, right? So, we got a cool team. What is this guy's name? Newt? Spooky Newt?
Spooky Newt.
All right, Spooky Newt. We got a cool team. And this is Sword Dog. Orange body would look dope. I agree. When are they going to make an iced coffee Pokemon? I'm down. Swordog. Swordoggo. And this is just a tree antler guy. Okay, so to win, we're going to have to... We have no fake out. We have very limited speed control. We have, like, Trick Room with the potential of, like, Airstream on Dragapult. We have no redirection to really write home about. We're going to have to, like... trick our opponents into losing somehow. How do we get them to just lose the game? I think Dragapult's a really underrated mon. So I think, like, Dragapult Zern could be really good. I think Dragapult and this guy. This is going to be our winning ticket, I think, is going to be Gene Simmons. And we should invest heavily in Gene Simmons. But as for what we want to do, we're going to use, like, Shadow Sneak with this guy. And we're going to policy proc a Dragapult. So we should start adding items here. We're going to use, like, a weakness policy here. We know this guy has to have the Rusted Sword. This guy's going to have to hold a Power Herb, which is going to make it so we can use a really cool move called Geomancy without having to wait two turns. It's normally a two-turn cast move. I'm still unsure on this thing. I'm really unsure. Now, we're not going to replace Gene. Gene's our winning ticket. It's our one shot. Otherwise, they just leave with, like, Incineroar and we lose. I think the Defiant's going to be really good. I'm actually thinking about scarfing it because it has a good base speed stat. And so, like, a scarf, one of these guys can just come in hot and destroy some fools. But we'll see when we get there. Trevenant's weird. There's a few different ways you can play Trevenant. Does it get Shadow Sneak? I don't know if it does. Huh. Yeah, it doesn't. I wish. That'd be really cool. Trevenant can be played a few different ways, but I do think, like, Trevenant is a really cool mon. Maybe we do have to cut it, though. I think if we cut Trevenant for something to take away some of that ghost weakness... That could be good. Let's see. I mean, we could obviously make the team better by adding, like, a Regieleki instead of the Trevenant, but, like, we'll see where we want to go. Guts is broken? No, Flame Orb is really bad on these guys. So, like, I'm going to tell you guys... I'm gonna go off topic here and explain to them why Flame Orb is bad.
Okay.
So, Flame Orb with, like, with the other ability, Guts is bad. It gives you a 1.5 attack boost. And then all they have to do is intimidate you once, right? All they have to do is intimidate you once and you go back down to neutral. Defiant has a lock-in. You can't ever really get intimidated without them losing the game. So it's also, Flame Orb takes your item slot. You can use Defiant without wasting your item slot. It's such a waste to go Guts in, like, a singles format. Maybe Psychic Normal type? Something like Oranguru. Oh, I got an idea. Do you want to use the monkey, the Oranguru?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, all right.
Instead of what?
Instead of the evil tree. Or we can cut Tomb Mold. One of these guys has to go, though.
Up to you.
The evil tree will bring the less... It has to be the evil tree.
Okay.
So we're going to use Oranguru, right? There's a couple different things that we can do with this. And I really think this is going to be game-changing levels of broken. We're going to put a choice scarf on it. And we are going to just instruct, like, our behemoth blades and our geos. So this is going to be good. I like this. I like where this is going. So let's see. What else do we really want to do from here? Infiltrator is probably better than... Pressure is really good. So we want to have Protect here. Just so we can actually get that up. Ooh, it gets Ally Switch. I didn't know that. So that's our redirection right there. And then probably just Icy Wind on this guy. And he's just going to be weird. this guy's going to have Choice Scarf, Inner Focus. So we're going to have... it gets a really cool move called Instruct. It makes whatever you target with Instruct use the same move that it just used, but we're going to be fast. So we're going to be instructing our own teammates and just using our own moves. Let's see. What else is really good to use? Like turn one. I'm going to put Ally Switch on it. And let's find a couple other things that can be really good. Oh, we'll put Trick on it. And then we should just put like some sort of attack. Maybe like Shadow Ball. Does it get Shadow Ball? It does. That's so good. So like we can just make this guy. We might put Shadow Ball. We'll see. Completely unrelated, but did you get that vibrant red with or without bleaching your hair?
It was blonde when I put the red on. Thank you.
All right, so let's go with Oranguru here. Energy Ball for Groudon Ogre. I think it would put something else because you don't really need to use Energy Ball versus them. Like, Oranguru gets a bunch of really cool attacks, but the fastest we can make an Oranguru here is going to be this. So as fast as it can get is going to be like 123 with a scarf. Is that... No, it's not right. Let's see. Oh, it's really weird. Why isn't it going up? I'm just going to refresh this page. It's being weird. All right. Got to trade Lugia anyway. I'm not going to trade Lugia right now, so... All right, now it's working. There we go, 168. So if we make it timid, and we can already outspeed base 100s, but if we make it timid, we can make our Zacian 183, underspeed that by 1 point while still outspeeding things like Tornadus and Thundurus. So you can see Thundurus set like this. You think Trick Room? We're not going to use Trick Room. Oh, you think Trick Room for the last move on a Choice Scarf set? That'd be kind of funny. Look at all these math numbers, right? So,
yeah,
see, Tornadus
glossed over already.
Tornadus gets to 179. So we're going to make our Zacian one speed slower than our Oranguru, so we can just go Instruct into Zacian. All right. CJ says, dude, one of the lessons learned in this IC, people underestimate Grimglass's outplay. Idoko's Kali Ice. Yep, I agree. It's really, really good. I think it's super, super good. Instruct Behemoth Blade. It's going to be nice. Are you going to make a vlog for the regional? Yeah, that's the plan. I'm going to be going to the regional and just filming a bunch of stuff and like vlogging basically all of it. Berry Symbiosis, not good. That's not good. This is what's good. So we want the full speed squad here. And we'll just go like 252. There's fine in case we actually need to attack. I don't know what attack I want to use though yet. Let's see. Does it get Brutal Swing? Ooh, pop the policy on the Dragapult! That's so sick. All right, so that means our Dragapult. We just have to make Dragapult 183 then, right? And then Oranguru outspeeds it by 1 point. And then we'll make Zacian 182, right? Oh my gosh, that's going to be so sick. And then we'll make a bulkier Zacian. So Oranguru can instruct to make it so if you bring it out after, it can go and instruct the Zacian to use double Behemoth Blade, but also we can use it and go for like turn one, like Choice Scarf, Brutal Swing into the Dragapult to proc its policy and just like one-shot them, and they can't stop it by Fake Out. So it's gonna be really cool. I know this is like really boring and tedious, but it's actually kind of cool. But we want to be like speed reduced, and we don't need to put our points here then. We can just go up here. So speed reduce, sorry, attack reduce and stuff like that. And then we'll just put our last four, like, right there is fine. All right. As for this guy, I don't know what we want to do with that yet. This guy's moveset's going to be pretty easy. So protect, geomancy, and then you just use Dazzling Gleam and Moonblast in this situation. What about Fake Out on Zacian? What about the Fake Out on Zacian? What about the Fake Out? We don't lead with Zacian. The way the team works is you're leading with other stuff. Are you actually going to use? Of course we are. What's the problem? I wouldn't add it if I didn't. Yo, we got a sub from Eddie Eggplant dropping the big Twitch Prime sub. Yo, can we just put up some subs up for that? Thank you. You ever tried Subzern? Once. I'm not a fan. I'll say that. I'm not a fan of Subzern. Well, especially in a form where you can just max it. Because the only reason you'd use sub is to stop like spores and things like that. You can just max it and use max Starfall. Sword Dog, though, we know most of our moveset. I think a 3 attacks Zacian is going to be good. So Protect, we'll go Sacred Sword, Play Rough, and Behemoth Blade. Alright, and as for its EVs, we don't really need to have, like, heavy attack investment. I'm a big fan of using a Zacian that's kind of like that with, like, a 108 here, because this lets you work well against other Zacians. We just put the last 36 in here. So again, the Zacian's made to, like, underspeed our Oranguru by one point, so we can always just come out and use Instruct with it. And again, I really like that we're in our focus, so we can't be taunted. Xerneas will mess with the EVs in a sec. Dragapult, the rest of our EVs can go, like, right here. Put 4-4 to use it optimally. 84 right there. One sec. Cool. And we'll just make it adamant. A little bit more optimal to use your EVs like this instead of, like, spending 8 EVs to get one more HP point. We can use 8 EVs to split it up in each 4 and put 1 in defense and spadef, so it's pretty nice. What fun and interesting Pokemon things, right, my dear?
Yes.
All right. Okay, so the rest of our stuff. Zacian's done. Dragapult's moveset. We're going to want the Phantom Force, obviously. We could make Special Pult if we wanted to, but I don't think we should. Dragon Darts. We probably still want Airstream, so, like, Fly is going to be good. And then, like, we should just go with Protect, probably. I mean, let me actually think about that. Do we even need Protect? Because we can always just do something different. Lots of physical, but yeah, but they're all mons that, like, can't be intimidated for the most part. Like, this is a clear body pult, so it doesn't really matter. And this is, like, a defiant mon. I like physical pult a lot more, too, but you just add Ally Switch. Yeah, that can turn into max guard. So we got Ally Switch here. We got Ally Switch here. We got Ally Switch here. The Degeneracy Incarnate. And, yeah. Let's pick this guy's set. So this guy gets a special Protect. I don't even know if we should use it, but, like, I'm going to do it. So we're going to put Obstruct there. We're going to put Giga Chad Impact. We're going to go for Knock Off. And then for this last move, I think you want the Close Combat. Because it doesn't get, like, Sucker Punch or anything. I think we just Life Orb this guy. And we are going to hit super hard. And that's the plan. And you still want to be timid. Sorry, still want to be jolly so we can outspeed base 90. So we're just going to actually just come up and just pop Kyogre's in the mouth. What happens if you instruct a faster Pokemon? So the way it's going to work is, if I were to instruct a faster, so, like, if my Zacian was faster than my Oranguru, I'd be able to go Behemoth Blade into Behemoth Blade. And I think that's something that I could change, right? I think I could change that to be played that way. Maybe I should. Miss the beginning, what does the Spirit Tomb do? Does Trick Room Countermon helping with speed control, Icy Wind outside of enemy TRs. There's no Trick Room on this team. It's made to look like it's Trick Room, but it's not. It's just Icy Wind for extra speed control. And maybe, yeah, so if you were to go instruct on something that's faster, it would just use the move that it already used. Maybe we should make the Zacian faster then. Yo, Eddie Eggplant gifting 5 subs! Oh my goodness. 5 gifted subs. So this is where we use this emote, right? And we put it all over the screen. And then this is where we use this emote. Everywhere, and we put, like, a bunch of them because they're gifted subs, and we take the emote wall and we go like this. Hold on, emote wall, put it right here because we got 5 sub gifts. Yo, we absolutely love to see that, and we put them all over the screen because Eddie Eggplant is the best person on the internet today. Thank you so much for that support, my friend. Hopefully you're having a good one. I was talking about opposing TRs, but yeah, with Shadow Sneak, it doesn't care about speed tiers. Yep. And then Zero also dropping the sub. 16 months. That's a long time.
Wow, yeah.
That's a good old-fashioned long time. Oh man, we got someone losing their shit over here. Having a little aneurysm party over there. But thank you so much, Eddie Eggplant. Really do appreciate it. And let's just get back to... I think I should make the Zacian faster, because we just want to make the Orangeru, I guess, a little bit slower than the Zacian. So that means Pulp is 183. Orangeru, we already saw, is 184. That means Zacian can go to 185, which means Zacian can actually, like, outspeed... let me just check this. That's the set I usually use. 185. I want to see if that outspeeds Whims. You're welcome. Thank you for everything you do. Well, thank you so much. That is just the kindest thing I've ever seen in my life. My life. All right, so let's make Zacian outspeed Whimsicott then, and make Orangeru be able to outspeed that. So, like, Whimsicott would be 252, Timid, goes to 184. So, yeah, 185 outspeeds Whims by 1 point, which is really, really nice. Like, we definitely would be taking those. Thank you for correcting me in that situation, and we can put our last 12 right here. Awesome. So, Zacian's still really, really good. Yeah, ads are annoying. I don't get to choose when they play. You know, if you subscribe, you don't get to see the ads. There you go. So, we have this guy here. We got this guy. So, this is done.
I like him.
Or the Orangeru?
Yeah.
You like Marley? You want to name him Marley? Yeah. I always mess this up. Does our dog have a Y or, like, two E's?
Two E's.
Two E's. All right. So, this is our dog. Do you want the shiny one or the regular one? What do you think his shiny looks like?
I mean, gray.
Pink. No, 238 no, is a pretty decent speed number. We don't technically need to have a lot of speed on Xerneas, I don't think. I think Xerneas being built a little bit bulkier is probably better. Then the problem is if we get like minus one or they have speed control, we go to 178, which is not a good number. So we want to be able to outspeed Thundies. So you want to get to 180 at least. I put in that four. And to outspeed Zacian, this outspeeds Zacian at plus two from the Geo, right? Hit to 150, you don't got to go that high. You really don't have to go that high. This outspeeds Thundy if we happen to get minus one by like a max strike or something like an Icy Wind or something. Or like an Electro Web. What do you think of Custap Snorlax? I think it's okay. What can your Orn outspeed? Our Orangeru outspeeds Genies. It outspeeds Genies. So that's really, really good. It's really good. Yeah, so I'm just going to put the four here so we outspeed Genies still. So 120, ooh, yeah, and they're not speed tying. See, it goes up like into the 182s. How does Instruct Geo work? Wouldn't it mean it's so slow since Xerneas doesn't use the herb? So the way it works is you go Geo, right? And you switch in your Orangeru. So, and then you go like turn two, you can do whatever you want. Like the Instruct Geo is a weird looking play, but it can work. It's just, this team doesn't use the Instruct Geo correctly, but it's hard to explain. I think that I don't really want full special attack either. I don't think I need full HP either. So this is going to go, we got to get to 230 is where like diminishing returns would start happening if we weren't using any other investment here. So we can put the rest of these points in bulk. I think heavy defense is going to be fine since we don't have any intimidators. So heavy defense is fine. Let's put about 60 in here and we'll throw the rest in special attack, which is going to be 52 with nature. And if it's not the right Xerneas spread, like if it's not great, we'll just switch it, but I think it's okay. So wait, Eevee's there. Eevee's there. Eevee's there. Eevee's there. Eevee's for Tomb Mold. What is our item going to be on this guy? What's a good item for this guy?
Heavy duty boots.
Heavy duty boots? You just want more Doc Martens.
You know how much I love heavy duty boots.
All right, let's see. What do we really want to do? What do we need this thing to do? Ally switch is what we need him to do. So Rocky Helmet? Yeah, that's fine. So Rocky Helmet, we'll go full. Obviously HP, we'll go with like a attack reduced nature so we can make our Shadow Sneak not one-shot our Pult. Have the weakness policy there. And then I think in terms of speed, we don't need any speed either. We just don't. But we still want to be attack reduced because we don't want to one-shot that Pult. We just go heavy defense. I think heavy defense with a Rocky Helmet is going to be fine. So something like 60 Spadef, 196 plus. Spirit Tomb's not a terrible Pokemon. That probably works just fine. Are we gonna win?
Yeah.
Okay.
I have faith.
You have faith, huh?
Yeah.
Somebody has to. All right, let's go. Let's go play some games.
Yeah.
Where's the ladder? Okay. All right, Zacian, Xerneas, they know! They have Sword Doggo and Antler Guy. Their nicknames aren't nearly as cool as ours, though.
No. What is that flower crown thing?
That's Comfey, the best Pokemon in the game.
Okay.
So, they have a big fairy team. So, that means Zacian Oranguru, like, cooks. I'm just going to leave with it. I don't see a problem with Zacian Oranguru here. We got Marley and Sword Dog. We don't need Intimidator, so we don't need Gene. They have their own Zacian, so it's going to be hard to use this guy, which means we want to bring this guy. We want to bring the Tomb Mold. And, like, Antler guys, okay, we can go for the ally switch into the Geo off that. So we take those. Alright, let's go. Someone's about to be taken the DPS. Someone's about to be just absolutely destroyed here. Instruct. So you can see our Oranguru's speed goes to 184, our Zacian's 185. So we can go Behemoth Blade. We're going to instruct our own guy. Instruct these. Behemoth Blade. Tailwind, like I care. Wild charge, like I care, bro. About to be getting popped. Do it again. Yo, we take those. Oh, that's funny. Xerneas, do it again. All right, that's funny. Goodbye, Xerneas. Power of Zacian compels us. Do you like the way the Sword Dog Marley combo is working?
Yes.
And again, we have like inner focus Oranguru. Like they can't break the Oranguru. Oh, we're dead probably. That's gonna kill us. Oh, they hit the Oranguru. They put respect on the Oranguru.
Oh, poor Marley.
Poor Marley. Yo, sacrificial benefits. We do be taking those. All right. Who do you realistically want to win with? Because we can win with either of these.
Antler guy.
All right, you choose Antler guy. That's the correct choice.
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, I heard how much Tomb Mold's been getting grief, so I figured...
You know what? They just don't... They gotta put some more respect on Tomb Mold. We just go for the big D-Gleam, and we just go for... Let me see. There's two turns left on Protect. Let's actually think about this. We can Geo and just Protect here, because we don't want to get Heat Wave crit. Taunt. That's fine. See, Mystical Fire. See, like, we don't want to be eating that. That's not what we're about. So we are just gonna go big deeps in your face. Actually, I better get the Whimsy off the board. Tomb Mold's gonna give the finishing blow to that Whimsicott.
Okay.
And we're gonna mess him up. Under pressure. That's the ability. Wow, we've just Fairy Aura boosted that. Never luckied. Oh, Drowsy's not gonna work because we got that Starfall Sashes up. You know, that we left him at 1%. Tomb Mold's gonna be able to deal the finishing blow.
Go Tomb Mold.
Go Tomb Mold. Tailwind, I never even heard of it, bro. You can reset the Tailwind if you want, but we're still gonna win. Feels good, man. Decorate your Auron. Instructed to decorate your Auron again. That's funny. Yep, Shadow Sneak. Not today. We take those. They're respecting Tomb Mold, as they should. And then we win. Did you think we would win any games?
No.
I'm also surprised.
Will we win?
Yeah, we win. We won. We used Tomb Mold was the reason we won.
That's what I like to hear.
That's what I like to hear. Yeet, delete, repeat. I don't think I can talk to them, so there's a new account. There we go. Oh, we can. Awesome. Wins up. 100% win rate right now.
Right.
Woo! All right. This team has one restricted in the Flying Whale. And has come... Carbink. Okay. They have Heracross, Cresselia. I don't think there's a problem with leading with, like, a bunch of the cool stuff. But I think in this game, we want to go with the Oranguru Dragapult and go for the Policy Proc like that. Then we want to bring something like Antler Guy and Sword Dog in the back. And the reason we want to lead with this one over Tomb Mold is because we want to be able to break the sash on that Zam that we see right there. Zam's a bit of an issue if it's full speed. So there's a few different things we could do in this situation. We can also, I mean, technically, we could just trick a Toy Scarf onto our Pult. Oh, man, there's so many cool options. We could Ally Switch here and Airstream. There's just so many cool options. I'm going to go for the Brutal Swing. And I'm going to go for the... We don't need to Airstream here. I think Phantasm is the right play into the Alakazam. So we're going to get a +2. We're going to be able to kill their Zam through a Sash, too. That's a cool point. So we hit that Zam right in the kisser. You love to see that. Policy proc'd the Newt. Phantasm takes out Zam. Drops the defense on the Kyogre. Don't really care if they have Ice Beam. Doesn't really matter. Spout's not going to do that much. It KOs the Oranguru, which is what we wanted. And now we just can bring in any of these. So in this situation, if they want to bring out the Cresselia, we'd win with Dragapult. If they want to bring out the Heracross, we'd still win with Dragapult. They want to bring an Arcanine, and Intimidate doesn't work there, so we probably want to bring Antwer Guy out in this situation, but, because basically we'll be able to be a big bully versus anything that they have.
Armadillo Lizard.
Armadillo Lizard.
What do those look like?
What is an oh, like a real Armadillo Lizard? That's nuts.
That sounds like something I'd name a Pokemon.
All right, so let's actually think about what we need to do in this situation. I don't think we need to do... I think we actually need to Moonblast that so we don't just lose our Pult there, because that's looking like a Specs Ogre right now. And we could just KO that, but I don't want to get Trick Roomed. Do we respect Trick Room in this house?
Oh, these guys are super cute.
We'll Geo. Yeah, we'll drop the Geo. Oh, they're maxing the Ogre. We take those. What is it? Oh, those are really cute.
Yeah.
I'll take two.
Okay.
All right, so we get a Geo off. They're going to get a Trick Room up. That's fine. Trick Room. Yep. We take those.
Thank you, boys.
And now we have big, strong, fast guys. And in the Trick Room, they got the Heracross, but like, I don't know about that one, Chief. I don't know about that one. They already maxed too, so we're going to win this one too. But they do have the Trick Room up. It reverses the speed. Yo, Moonblast, Dragapult, that's our EV spread. Look at that, perfect EV spread, making so Zern doesn't have to do that split, take that single target damage. They get a Moxie boost, that's fine. They're not Moxie boosted. And Swordog in the back. 100% win rate. You'll love to see that. That was a Fairy Aura boosted Moonblast, and Dragapult hit that like a champ. Easy peasy. We do be loving to see that. 100% win rate. Zacian Ray. Okay. With Rhyperior. So I wonder if that's going to be like Trick Room Whims, probably going to be potentially G-Max Blastoise. That's a cool team. That Zard's actually pretty scary. So we want to go with like Dragapult here probably. Dragapult's probably just the best option, I would say. Because it can deal with a lot of those while also like ally switching us away from danger so we can correctly use our Xerneas. So I think something like Dragapult Xerneas can be really good because we can also go protect Airstream and get a plus one onto our Xerneas, which would be really nice. So I think this is a decent play. We could also... Actually, screw this. Let's just do this again. Draggable Eevee spread. Yo, we love to see it. We're going to go with these two again. And then Ant or Guy. I think Pult's still really good here if used correctly, though. I really do think it's good. That big ally switch is great. Yeah, Pult's fine. All right, let's see what they got. We might lose this one. Tombreon dropping the sub. Yo, thank you. 26 months. We do be loving to see that. All right, so in this situation, that Ray is a big problem. Instructees. We're going to try and just get it off the board first turn. Hello, friends. Oh, man, you're going to miss the action. Yeah, we're gonna get messed up here. Oh my gosh. Swordog flinch, but Swordog, you've abandoned Swordog in his hour of need!
Oh wait.
No, it's fine. Wait. Alright, round two. They got an Airstream up. So they're gonna be able to KO Oranguru probably. Aqua Jet. That's not how that works. Oh, it is how it works. It's Absorb Bulb! That's so sick! Oh my god, that's so funny! Absorb Bulb, what? That's fucking weird. Okay, it's fine. Things are okay. All right, what are we doing here? Can't leave your sword dogs hanging. That's right. Can't just leave sword dog all high and dry. We want to protect the Zern and heart switch in the pull. And then we'll go ally switch Geo, and then we'll try and win the game off that. That was nutty. There's the quake. We're not dead yet. Muddy water. They're gonna take out the pull. All right, so we got one shot, one opportunity. Mom spaghetti. Can we get the win or not?
Yeah.
All right, if you think so.
I think
I have faith in you.
I have faith in my team.
All right. That was some scary shit. Freaking Absorb Bulb Rayquaza. That's not normal. Earth Power. We take those. Bob Weave. Moving Groove. Antwer Guy. About to be popping off right now. They got a plus two Spadef boost. Do we just Geo again? Actually, do we just Geo again? Yes, it is them who is wrong. No, okay, they're switching to Whims. Okay. Geo again. We need two of these, guys. We need it so we can one-shot the Zacian. Don't taunt me, bro. Don't do it. Fake tears, that's fine. I don't give a shit. Geo, two of them. All right, we win now. Probably. We got two Geos. We can pop that Zacian if they have it so hard. Tailwind, that's okay. There's the sash on the Whims. All right, so Tailwind's up. Is Zacian? Zacian's faster than us. No! We almost had it, my dear. I think we almost had it. All right, you can go use the restroom. It was your abandonment of the sword dog in his hour of need. Just slash. All right, we're gonna win this one. This guy uses Flygon. That's the worst Pokemon in the game, right there.
I've heard about Flygon.
Yeah, Flygon sucks. we can leave with anything. Well, let's just leave with these. They're dead. We won. We don't even need to like play the game correctly. We can just do whatever we want, and then we win. It's dead. That guy's dead too. They're both actually dead. You want to see me KO him? Want to see me do it again? There. I've won the game. We're going to hit one, and then we're going to hit the other one. They're both going to die, and they're going to send their other two mons out in the back, and we're going to hit one, and we're going to hit the other one, and we're going to win the game.
All right.
All right. Yeah, giant moth thing. Mothra, right? Could Mothra, work pretty well with antler guy. Is still going to die. Dead.
Whoa.
Is dead. Flygon sucks. And then, you know what? You're dead, too. Oh, almost dead. Very, very close to being dead. Almost. We can just kill him next turn. It's okay. Xplod's a cool Pokemon. I like this guy. When he attacks in the game, he opens up his mouth like three times the size of his whole body.
Looks very mad.
He's like, he goes like Kirby status. All right. Max Guard. Not bad. I'm like out of Behemoth Blades. Just wasting them out here. Should we max Marley?
Yeah.
All right.
Big Marley. That's
Big
what
Marley,
we need.
Let's go. Absolutely massive Marley out here. Oh my gosh. My boy. Yeet. Delete, repeat, get him, Marley. Mess him up. Dude, the outplay. I just want to talk about that. That was an outplay, because if we went for the instruct and got cursed body, then we would have had no damage, okay? Umbra may be my favorite, but Gulpin is probably my spirit Pokemon. Yo, Gulpin D's, know what I'm saying? Gulpin?
Yeah, look all these up.
Okay, go. You gotta also Google what it evolves into. Gulpin D's. Do you look at what it evolves into? And like that's what it does that.
Oh, I love him.
Yeah, it's our dog. Yeah, they look like that. That's what they look like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, all that's right. Perfect.
Groudon, Yveltal. And Gastro. I mean, they have the Regieleki, which is a big problem, but we can just go big Gene. Gene's a good Pokemon here. He's a good boy. So we're going to go Gene, and like Sword Dog would pull attention away from like those things. They're going to go with the big Zard. So like we need to go with something that can stop Zard. We need to go with an ally. It's time for the mold. Breaking the mold out here. Two mold. Look at this. There's no way that any person that actually plays the game is ready for this sort of lead. Like it just doesn't like work that way. The game's not built to handle this level of like busted, broken, next level outplay. Let's go. Ooh, I'm so good at Pokemon. I'm so good at Pokemon. What drug? Like, I care. This is going to be a Sash Lucky. We're trying our best to outplay that. We're trying our best to break that Sash. And then Gene will outspeed that Zard when we get our chance to get our fingers on it. Because right now, we've rolled into a false insecurity. We protect it, which means our protect's on cooldown, which means they're going to blow their load on this guy. And Tomb Mold is going to have to take the big hit. So we're going to kill the Lecky, make the Zard slow, and then kill the Zard next turn. We're making them disrespect Tomb Mold, and we're going to punish them for it. There's the max, obviously. Ooh. They're going to go into this slot right here.
That's cool.
But we're not there anymore. Where are you looking, huh? Mm-mm. Where are you looking? Can't see me. I'm not even over there anymore, bro. Right. Oh, my goodness. Making plays for days. And the speed control. That's what we want to see. That's what I'm talking about. We can send out any of these right now. That's still a big problem. Has to be... Let's think about this realistically. How do we win? We send out Antler Guy. Yep, that's the right play. We get the Geo up, and then we don't die to the Wildfire boost. So we go Geo up. And we get a second speed drop on the Zard. and then we'll outspeed basically everything that we need. Electrobond Defiant, I wish, right? So you can hit the, you can hit Gene if you want, but like the Geo's up is going to give us a plus 2 speed up, which means the Wildfire, only way it kills us if he crits. Doesn't crit. Not going to do it. Not going to do it. Goodbye. I mean, they could still win, but like we're in a good spot. All thanks to 2 Molt. Its sacrifice was not in vain. All
right.
So let's see what they got. They're thinking. Oh, they're switching in the Yveltal. Okay. Hey, go nuts. Yeet, delete, repeat. Yeet. 2 HP. No! It was supposed to die. That was supposed to kill it. That's that's really unfortunate. Yeah, that's bad. We're going to lose our Zern now. I'm sad. I'm sad. This is me. I'm sad. Oh, that's really, really bad. And the Yveltal... Why didn't the Yveltal get a speed drop? Oh, he airstreamed, right? Oh, that's really, really unfortunate. Wildfire's still ticking. They can go with, like, an Electroweb into, like, a heat wave here. Their last one on the back is Groudon. So, like... Ugh. This is, if they have heat wave, we lose. Electroweb, yep, that has to happen. I can't stop it. Defiance up. Plus 2 attack. Foul play. Oh, we're weak. We got him. Yeet. We're gonna take him. I think we might be able to do it. It depends on how fast the Groudon is. That's what it's gonna come down to. How fast you think the Groudon is? 123. If their Groudon has significant speed investment, they will win. If it has no significant speed investment, we win. They're also max speed Groudon, so they'll outspeed you. If they're max speed. If they hit both their P points. No! No, they got it! Ah, we lost.
We're close.
Never lucky. Never lucky. Which one do you like?
I was looking at the egg guy.
Egg guy.
Executor? Right. Is that?
Executor. All right. So okay. I've led most of the games. What do you want to lead in this one? You pick.
I don't know. Spooky Newt?
Spooky Newt, okay.
And, Sword Dog.
Sword Dog, okay. Aggressive. We gotta bring Antler Guy. You get to pick one of these to bring in the back.
Gene Simmons.
Okay. Alright, let's go. So we have Sword Dog, Mir, but they're faster than we are. So what we need to do is get some speed boost. They can go for a Behemoth there. They could basically click the button that goes Behemoth into this slot and press Precipice Blades, and they get a double KO, and we would automatically lose the game.
Okay.
That's fun, right? Fun and balanced gameplay? Fair and balanced gameplay, right? We're going to have to ally switch, and we're going to have to Behemoth Blade this Groudon and hope that we crit. Oh my god! That's a misplay and a half for me. That's a misplay from them, too. Both of us are bad!
Well, that's fortunate, I guess.
Yeah, we do be taking those. I guess at this point, our only outplay would be to, like, Airstream into that slot and hope that they don't take out Azoshing. Because we need Azoshing to get speed control, that'll be theirs. Yep, so they're respecting Ally Switch. We're playing around Precipice Blades right now. What trippy showdown thing is this? This is just a showdown. This is what it looks like. So we're going to respect them over going to the Groudon slot, so we're just going to nuke the Azoshing in this situation. Can't worm one there. Do I need a Phantasm? Do I need to Airstream? I don't need to do any of those. I think the Phantasm is better because there's less switch-in. So if you want to switch in like a... yeah, that's fine. Perfect. Awesome. So Groudon's going to be able to hit its moves, but like, it doesn't matter. You miss on the Pulp, we take those. That's fine. We traded Zacians, and we have a speed boost here. They haven't used their Max Turns yet, but we're in a great spot. So no matter what they send out, it's probably going to be the Executor. We don't necessarily care. I think it's a great time to go Antler Guy. Why is Sword Dog with Sun? Why not? So there's the Heatran. Oh my god. They're busting out the Heatrans. Heatran supremacy out here. We just gotta get that Heatran off the board. Or do our best, you know. So we're gonna drop a defense drop on the Heatran. Almost gets the KO. They're gonna do big damage to Zern. We don't wanna, yeah, go for the taunt. Taunt's a little bit slow. I'm surprised they went with that, but this is okay. We just gotta click the Groudon and get him off the board. And Phantom Force is fine into Heatran, because this defense dropped. They're wasting their Sun turns, so even if they have Eggy in the back, it's fine. We're going to get it. Precipice Blades won't kill the Zern. Does a lot, but it won't kill. Deeps. You can flash cannon the antler guy, then we just get a free KO into, well, a free bring into my boy, Gene. Gene versus Cress? Talk about a match made in heaven. Knock off. So let's see. If you're going to ally switch here, we'd KO there. We would. It's better to double into the C-Trans slot just because we care more about the Cress, I think. Because you can't protect. And this plays on ally switch. Yeah, this is just what. There's the ally switch. I'm so good at Pokemon. Have you ever seen someone as good as me? I swear, in my entire life, I don't think I've ever seen anyone as good as myself. Flamethrower ain't gonna do it, Chief. That ain't it. But this is what my Shredon looks like, because my Shredon's sick. We're gonna go close combat. And we win. We did it! We won!
Yay.
You picked the Pokemon that won this game. Yeah. The big Max Heatran. Your Gene Simmons. Chopple? Oh my gosh, never lucky. But it's fine. We still win. But like, that's crazy. Oh man. Better late than never on that Max. Show them what you're working with, Dragapult. You can Max Guard. I'll just do it again. And then we win. Feels great, man. Steel Spike blocked. Spooky Newt delivering those big KOs. This guy says no fair. Why is it not fair? They used Ally Switch. They're trying to argue their case when they tried to steal the win from us. They played degenerate, and we still won. Feels good, man. We beat down the Ally Switch villains.